Good evening, everybody.
It's been a long time, Mr. Robertson.
It's been too long. Christmas officially starts this evening.
And we're keeping our distance.
Normally we would grab one another and do a combination of the salsa and the waltz.
Spinning on our heads, all sorts of things. We normally be doing
it. But we're going to take it easy, aren't we? We were very grateful. This music makes me want to dance. It's an interesting feel. Very different to normally. There's a lot of...
Lovely. Is it Joe still on the piano?
Is this live? I was very grateful yesterday evening when Boris Johnson didn't cancel this, because it was touch and go, wasn't it, for a while?
Yes.
But we're here now, and I'm very pleased that we've got you here as well, because from our experience, we've been doing this for a number of years, and it's the most wonderful evening of the year. And what a fantastic set that has been put together by Jenny Lewington-Chislett and the tech team. Can we give them a big round of applause? Doesn't it look amazing? It's fantastic, isn't it?
Strictly Come Dancing is one of our really important events of the year, so we're so glad to have it back with us this year. This year's Year 8 dancers have not had the same amount of time as previous Year 8 dancers for anything, actually. They, you know, if you think about the performance they did at the start of this academic year, when they'd lost so many rehearsals trying to put the Harlequin dance together, and they did so well. And again, you know, with a slightly squeezed rehearsal schedule, they've managed to learn 3 dances, choose one of them, and get to the final here this evening. And what's been lovely, actually, talking to the students backstage, is they were sharing how so many of the dancers that didn't get through were actually really close when it came to judging those heats. So a lot of work has gone into teaching a lot of children to dance in Year 8, and may that continue.
Absolutely. We call it the green room back there. They were also sharing a lot of Skittles and Cokes. There's a lot of energy is going to come out onto the floor tonight, and we're very much looking forward to it. So, shall we get on with it and bring them out?
Yes, we could, actually.
Let's bring out our contestants.
Come on, the contestants. That's more like it.
It's building. Now, we need a lot of audience participation tonight. They've got energy, but you're going to give them your energy to really pump them up.
Is anybody
here? We go. Come on, contestants. Come on. Look at this. Don't they look fantastic?
Fantastic!
Wow. You look absolutely brilliant. We can't wait to see you dance. I know that you're all really excited. And we've got a friend. We're warming the audience up for you. They're going to get louder, and they're going to encourage you a lot more, I know. And they're not going to let our judges say anything bad, I promise you that. So look forward to this evening. We can't wait to see you dance.
We've got 3 categories of dance here that you can see, actually, from their costumes. I was able to identify them from their costumes backstage. So we've got the jivers in the middle, we've got the waltzers over there on stage left, and we've got the salsa here on stage right. So we've got a real treat in store for you this evening.
Okay, let's hear it again for our contestants. Okay, off you go, guys.
I think, Mr. Robertson, I haven't mentioned the trophy.
Oh, the trophy.
This evening we're going to be, they're going to be dancing, hopefully, so that one couple tonight is going to pick up this wonderful Strictly Come Dancing trophy.
It's fantastic, isn't it, huh? Look at that.
It's been with us now for about 14, 15 years.
Well, it used to be half the size, so something's happened.
Well, I have to say, I made the original trophy. This is actually a cake decoration. This is a pen holder. This is a cake decoration. And I had a much smaller bauble on it when I made it originally. But most of the glass off that is in the boot of my car. This is a new bauble, but it's a really prestigious trophy to win. And somebody's going to have it sitting on their mantelpiece for a while.
Absolutely. Now, unfortunately, we do have to bring out some judges. Now, you've got to take them with a pinch of salt. We've got a real combination this year, haven't we? We've got some fantastic expertise, and we've got Mr. Mile.
Well, Mr. Mile did have something of a career in contemporary dance, I understand.
I'll press him on that when he comes out. So, let's give him a warm welcome, actually. Shall we introduce our judges?
As Mr. Robertson said, we've got some expertise amongst our judges this evening.
Look at this.
It's wonderful to have Imogen Bagley back here being a judge. Imogen, if you've come to previous Strictlys, you'll remember Imogen from leading the Latin and Ballroom Seniors group. Some of you are nodding your heads here out in the theatre. So Imogen comes with some pedigree herself as a dancer and as a choreographer. Welcome back, Imogen. And we've also got Tim Woodford. Tim was actually the originator of the of Latin and ballroom sort of moving to a different level here at Ballets. When Tim was in year 8, he was already competing at a very high level, and so we wouldn't let him compete in Strictly Come Dancing. How mean is that, actually?
But he's been to every show, hasn't he? And he's always been fantastic at coming on and demonstrating his prowess. And it's lovely to now have you back as a judge, Tim. Welcome back.
Thank you.
There it is. And for the second year, right, it's a little bit like, third year running, is it? Because normally we have on a single desk. But
it's like
a
university challenge, isn't it?
I was going to say blankety blank, but...
Well, you watch different sorts of shows to me.
So, Miss Holmes, that is true. Welcome back. For the third year, you rightly correct. Are you looking forward to the evening? And it's good to have you back, because it was touch and go, wasn't it? But you're here.
I'm here.
And your hat is wonderful. Is it small because you're far away, or is it... Okay.
And Miss Holmes actually does come with some pedigree of dance as well. So she was very involved with the Harlequin dance. She wrote the narrative to the Harlequin dance and is known to do lots of sort of dancing to 90s pop numbers at the odd nightclub when she's allowed to go.
Yeah. And of course, Mr. Mile, welcome back. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Mile. A popular judge, some would say. Are you looking forward to the evening, Mr. Mile?
Absolutely. It's always an honour to be here. I am glad I'm bringing the experience to the panel. And as you say, the expertise. I think of judging as an interpretation. And I can't wait to interpret the dancers this evening. It's going to be great.
Fantastic. We look forward to hearing your words of wisdom this evening. So, ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for our judges. So we're going to start with the salsa, aren't we?
Yes.
And just to set the scene, we've got Miss Hindley and Mix Tucker here, who are some of the staff who have been teaching the students this year. And we're going to come to you for a little bit of guidance on what we should be looking for in this salsa.
Okay, so the salsa is a fun and cheeky number. We're looking for lots of hip action and shimmies. You can see it's originated from Cuba, and there's New York styles as well. The dancers are working in a 4-4 time, but they're actually doing 3 steps within that. It's about having fun on stage, and there's some tricks and armography, we said, didn't we? Yeah. There we go.
Thank you. I think we've got it. So let's get on with things. Shall we introduce our first couple?
Yes, do you want me to? Because
hang
I'm
on,
holding
hang on,
the
hang
sheet.
On. We need to, let's get some. Shall we introduce our first couple? Okay, let's hear it big time for Genevieve and Nikita. Fantastic, ladies and gentlemen, Genevieve and Nikita. Come on, you two. Let's come over here. We'll have a little chat with you before we before we get the judges' thoughts. Come on, you've come here, Genevieve. So there you go. What did that feel like?
Stressful, but really, 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 really fun.
And give me a little sense, Nikita, of how you've prepared for this evening.
Well, I had 2 days to prepare, so it was very rushed. But it was very exciting, yeah.
Well, it's always a tough gig opening the show, and I have to say I think you've done a fantastic job because they really loved it. But of course, the people that we really need to impress are that four over there. So shall we see what they've got to say?
Who am I going to ask for the first comment from? Have we decided?
Who do you trust the most?
Well, I've got Mr. Mile next to me, so I'll just start with Mr. Mile and let him kick off with the judging scoring. So, Mr. Mile.
Thank you. Can I just say, first of all, what a fantastic opening to the show. I think another round of applause for that. Absolutely. You were clearly enjoying yourselves. If I could go a bit more technical, I've got some lovely extended arms, which is wonderful. So I really enjoyed it. Thank you very much.
Mr. Mile, and Imogen, would you like to pick up on that?
Absolutely, yes. Let's hear it for this. Okay, so we're now going to get some scores, aren't we? We're going to get some scores from our judges. An 8. Another 8. Had a wardrobe malfunction. Another 8. And an 8. There's consistency for you. Very good. Fantastic start. Take your seat, girls. That's a wonderful start to the evening. And then we'll introduce our next couple. Thank you, judges. So, second couple dancing the salsa this evening. Please give a warm welcome for Lucy and Monty.
Thank you.
Lucy and Monty, ladies and gentlemen. Lucy and Monty.
I think it was you, Mr. Robinson. Well, Lucy, you said you were really nervous backstage. In fact, you said, is there anybody in the audience? It's not full, is it? So what was it like performing?
Quite scary.
Quite scary. Did you enjoy it?
Yeah.
Who was in charge of the choreography? Was it a combined thing, or did you take the lead?
It was a combined thing, but Lucy took the lead.
Very generous of you. And let's have a look, then, what these judges think of the dance.
Should we come to Miss Holmes?
I thought it was brilliant.
Your armography was absolutely superb, with real extension there. And I really like your jump, and I don't know if this is a technical term, but I like your twirls. The twirling was excellent.
Thank you, Miss. Very good, very good. Yeah, can't disagree with that. Tim.
Right, my mic is working, fantastic. Well, I only wrote one word down, which was together, and I think that's really, really important. I love the little moments that the two of you had where you sort of stopped for a second, check in with each other so you could all move, you could both move off together, which is very easy to make the dance look very static, but it didn't in this case. You guys, you had those moments, but you kept it moving and you moved up together, and I thought that was incredibly impressive, and that takes a lot of rehearsal, and you nailed it. So very, very impressed. Thank you.
Thank you, Tim.
Thank you.
Some lovely comments.
So let's see how that turns into scores, shall we?
Close one this evening. We're getting that feeling, aren't we?
Yes, we're going to have to get some differentiation in here somewhere.
Okay, so let's give it up for our next couple dancing the salsa. It's Alfie and James.
Vem maga a lenha, rojão, traz a lenha pro fogão, vem fazer armação. Hoje é dia de sol, alegria de coió, é curtir o verão.
Vem maga a lenha, rojão, traz a lenha pro fogão, vem fazer armação. Hoje é dia de sol, alegria de coió, é curtir o verão.
Yeah.
There it is. Let's hear it up for James and Alfie. Whoa, 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 whoa. Well, I want to go on holiday with you two. Where'd you get those shirts?
I got mine from a friend.
We'll exchange names later on. That was excellent, guys. And the audience nearly kept in time with the clapping. They lost their way a little bit at the start, didn't they? But you overcame that. It was really good. That's a great little dance you got there. Shall we come over to the judges for some comments, please?
Well, I really, really loved your interpretation of the basic step. So, I mean, I'm sure everyone could see the way that you started out was that really, really classic salsa basic step. And the way that you then used that, you had that lovely moment where you both kind of turned around with each other. And I just thought that was such an interesting way of using that step and not keeping it very kind of linear and quite boring. And it just added those layers and layers, and I love the way that you continue to do that throughout the whole thing. So, in my opinion, it just continued to build, and it felt really, really exciting.
Thank you, Tim. Some nice comments.
Mr. Mile, would you like to add your technical expertise?
Someone wake him up.
Thank you very much. Thank you guys very much indeed. It reminds
reminds me of me on a Friday evening, so thank you very much indeed. I have to say, I really enjoyed this. So I thought, as Tim was saying there, there's a real focus here on the technique. I thought particularly on the footwork, you'd clearly carry that really carefully, and that was really fantastic. Lots of armography, which was great as well, and those extended arms, so thank you very much. I thought there was a really sort of nice sort of synchronisation between the two of you as well. So I really enjoyed that. And the shirts also topped it off as well. So thank you very much indeed. Well done.
Thank you so much. It almost sounds like he knows what he's talking about, doesn't it? Okay, so let's get some numbers, shall we? Judges. Another 8. A 7. A 7. And a 7. Well done, guys. Some good numbers. Okay, you grab your seats. You're over there. That's it, you're over there. Okay, so we've got our fourth couple dancing the salsa. Please give a warm welcome to Fergus and Lizzie.
Hey, yo, big wave. Tell him I come. Small time alongside JW.
My bestie and your bestie sit down by the fire. Your bestie says she want parties, so can we make these flames go higher? Talking about hey now, hey now, hey now, hey now. I go, ane. Chucking more fina, anane. Chucking more fina, ane. Start my truck, let's all jump in. Here we go together. Nice cool breeze and big palm trees. I tell you, life don't get no better. Talking about hey now.
Fergus and Lizzie! That's it! There it is! I want to go where you're going! That was amazing! Tell me, Fergus, have you done much dancing before?
I mean, I do dancing at home when we've got music on, but I don't do any lessons.
There's no better place to do it, I'm telling you, that's fantastic. Let's just come forward a little bit, shall we? And Lizzie, give me a sense of what it's like to dance on the stage in front of the crowd.
It's quite bright.
It's quite nice that you can't see any of them, no disrespect, but you know.
Yeah, it makes it a lot easier.
It does make it a lot easier. Okay, so shall we come over for some comments from the judges?
Thank you, Jim.
Judgment time.
A 9.
Well done, very good, lovely. So let's give a big warm welcome for our last salsa couple. It's Noah and Nikita.
Yeah. shake, shake, Sinora, shake your body line. Shake, 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 Sinora, shake it all the time. Work, 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 Sinora, work your body line. Work, 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 Sinora, work it all the time. My girl's name is Sonora, I tell you friends I adore her. And when she dances, oh brother, she's a hurricane in all kinds of weather. Jump in the line, rock your body on time. Okay, I believe you, jump in the line, rock your body on time. Okay, I believe you, jump in the line, rock your body on time. Okay, I believe you, jump in the line, rock your body on time. Whoa. Shake, shake.
Let me just find my remote. I think we're just going to press that pause button on the music.
Should we do that one again? We're going to do that one again. Should we run it? The music stopped the wrong time. Are you all right with that, guys? Yes! Excellent!
Sonora, I tell you friends I adore her. And when she dances, oh brother, she's a hurricane in all kinds of weather. Jump in the line, rock your body on time. Okay, I believe you, jump in the line, rock your body on time. Okay, I believe you, jump in the line, rock your body on time. Okay, I believe you, jump in the line, rock your body on time. Shake, 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 Sinora, shake your body line. Whoop. Shake, 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 Sinora, shake it all the time. Work, 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 Sinora, work your body line. Work, 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 Sinora, work it all the time.
Well done, Peter and Nora. I'm so glad, actually, we got you to do that again. Otherwise, we wouldn't have seen that flashy, nice, what would we call it, Nikita?
Walkover.
That very, very impressive walkover. Fantastic, both of you. So we had a lot of rehearsal time on this, would you say?
I mean, we have rehearsed as much as we could, but obviously Nikita's also got Genevieve to rehearse with, so we have to share the love, you know.
Well, it seemed very well shared, I have to say, Noah. Excellent. So, shall we see what the judges have got to say about you two then?
Imogen, can we come to you? Thank you, Jim. That's fine. Mr. Mark?
Thank you. What fun. Great fun. And we see it from the beginning. I have to say, I think when we look at the sort of whole performance as a whole, I really just went, they're loving this. And as an audience, that's so wonderful to watch as well. So thank you very much. Yeah, maybe smile. So I love sort of the choreography. There's a lot of choreography in that. You really use the space well, the floor. You're working together really well, which is fantastic. And I should say as well, you know, real character shown to do it twice over. So well done. But yeah, I really enjoyed it. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you, Smile.
Can we see the scores on the doors?
That's it.
Shortly, they're going to present those scores on the board behind us.
And while they're doing that, I can say thank you to two of our fantastic choreographers, Mrs. Hindley and Mrs. Tucker. We're going to present the medals to all of the Strictly finalists,
and the winners of the salsa category.
Completely, of course, because they're all winners from their own respective classes. So everybody's a winner tonight in that respect. But of course, one couple will go through to the final at the end. Any small talk?
There we are.
So we can see that our winners are Nikita and Noah from AB. Well done, Nikita and Noah. Some wonderful dancing. So well done, everybody. I hope you enjoyed it. Let's give another final round of applause to our salsa dancers this evening.
Thank you very much.
Well done, everyone. Up you go.
And we're moving on to the next category of dance, aren't we? And is that the waltz
It is the waltz. It's a very special part of the evening, very emotional for me. I almost get carried away every time we do this one. But shall we go to Mix Tucker and see what we're looking for, maybe?
Absolutely. So, Mix Tucker, this is the waltz. Can you tell us what we should be and what our judges over there should be looking for in a waltz?
Yes, so the waltz is one of the oldest of the ballroom dances originating in Europe. So we've gone from South America and Cuba in the salsa, and now we're moving into the European style of ballroom dances with the waltz. Within the waltz, we will see a 3-4 timing in the music, 1-2-3, 1-2-3, and we'll be expecting the dancers to be stepping on time with the music. We'll also be looking for a high elbow and held chest and torso.
Thank you very much indeed, Mix Tucker. High elbows. Right. Looking for that frame.
We've got it. So let's give a big warm welcome to our first waltz couple this evening. It's Ella and it's Will.
This could be our fairy tale.
Will and Ella, ladies and gentlemen, well done both of you. That was wonderful. Come on over here. Fantastic. I must say, that's beautiful. I really enjoyed that. You took me somewhere I've not been yet this evening. Will, the waltz, is that a tough dance?
Not really. You just have to get, if you get the footwork and you link it together and you have a strong concentration, it's fine.
Well, you made it look easy, I have to say. And Ella, you were fantastic. You really worked well together. I'm not a judge. I don't know what I'm talking about, but I know what I like, and I like that dance together. So well done, both of you. Fantastic. Wouldn't you agree, studio audience?
You're getting above yourself, Mr. Robertson.
There's a camera over there. Now then, who are we coming to first? Someone who knows what they're talking about. Tim.
Well, opening a category is never an easy feat. So congratulations, first off, for that one. I wrote down three things. I wrote down elegant, intimate, and calm. And I think those are three really, really important words, and are words that are associated with the waltz. I love the fact that you stuck together, and it did feel really, really intimate to me. And I mean, I couldn't tell if you had any nerves whatsoever, which in itself is a fantastic feat of performance. So congratulations.
Thank you, Tim. Ms. Holmes?
It really, really
was.
You copied, though. You're cheating.
Sorry, yeah. but also, I could really see the concentration on your faces as well. And it is a hard dance to dance, I think. You were really in time with one another. And also, your choice of music was lovely as well. Sound of Music, fantastic musical. So, well done. Really good rise and fall. Yeah, very good, right, thank you. Yep. Rise and fall there as well from you too, so well done.
Thank you, Sarah. Lovely comments. Nice comments, huh? Very good. So, should we turn those words into numbers, please?
7.
Four sevens, very good. Well done. Okay, we've got a second couple dancing the waltz this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Amelia and Lachlan.
This could be our fairy tale. They'll play the villains for our sword. I could be the
Amelia and Lachlan, ladies and gentlemen, that was lovely.
That was so elegant, actually. Such a contrast, actually. The last time I saw the two of you were dancing to a bit of show jazzy stuff, weren't you, in here? And you were doing some rock and roll dancing. So it only goes to show what talent our students have got. Really impressive. Okay, guys, should we have a listen to what the judges have got to say?
Imogen?
when you went into Promenade and Travel Cross, you kept both your heads high, you have such length in it, and the softness of your arms, when you were reaching through, you used every part, your wrist, your fingers, it kept everything as light as a waltz should be. So thank you.
Thank you, Andrew. Mr. Mile?
Thank you. I think one of the things I really love about waltz in particular is the ability to tell stories through the dance, and I absolutely think I saw a story here from the very beginning. The start was very poignant, you know, elegant is the word also being used, but I think Miss Mountford mentioned that a few minutes ago, but that poignancy at the beginning. Constant rise and fall. Even when you were separated as a pair, there was still that rise and fall all the way through. And I thought your timing of the music was very good, so that emphasis on the first beat, every three, was really, really clear, and that footwork really synchronized. So I really enjoyed that, thank you very much indeed.
Promising. So, shall we see those scores?
A 9.
Okay. Okay, there's some big scores. Okay, let's welcome our next couple dancing the waltz. Please welcome Isha and Marcus.
This could be your fairy tale. Come away with me. Come away with me, and I will write you a song. Come away with me on a bus.
Isha and Marcus, ladies and gentlemen, that was wonderful. Fantastic. Wow, that was great. Let me come and ask you a couple of questions. That was really lovely. Are you glad it's over, or would you like to do it again?
I'm quite glad it's over.
So I won't ask you to do it again. I'd love to see it again. That was really wonderful, fantastic. Let's get some nice comments from the judges, shall we? Miss Holm.
Really emotional, actually. I thought you had quite an emotional connection there. And you're both really nice on your feet. I like your matching costumes. That worked really well for you. I thought it kind of, you know, brought you together. Yeah, there was a lovely lead in there as well, halfway through, which again was a little bit different. So well done overall, really good.
I was very impressed. I think the song choice you had was absolutely fantastic. It's one of my favourite waltzes to dance to whenever I've had the opportunity. And one thing that I think you nailed was your timing. And as we mentioned before, it was stressed how important that 3-4 timing actually is. And you guys, from the moment you set off in hold, kept that the whole way through. And that's really quite a tricky feat, and again, requires a lot of rehearsal. So I was very, very impressed. And I mean, the storytelling in that was out of a fairy tale. So I was very impressed. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Tim. Lovely, lovely words. Can we back those words up with some numbers, please?
An 8.
Wow, an 8. Another one. 8. And an 8. 4-8, guys. Well done. Really good. Okay, we've got our fourth couple then, dancing the waltz. Please. Give a warm welcome to Jemima and Noah.
This could be your fairy tale.
I found a love for me. Darling, just dive right in. Follow my lead. Well, I found a girl, beautiful and sweet. Well, I never knew you were the someone waiting for me. 'Cause we were just kids when we fell in love, not knowing what it was. I will not give.
Hold for all that time. I don't know whether you're expecting the music to stop a bit sooner. That was lovely, both of you. Have you enjoyed working on that dance? And can I ask you, did you choose the dances that you put into the finals? Did you, or did you, were you chosen to do waltzing or salsa? Or you got to pick, so you chose this dance as yours. Really lovely dance. So let's see what the judges have got to say, Mr. Robertson.
Who are we coming to? I think we're going to come to Mr. Mile first.
Thank you. First of all, Noah, great minds think alike. I like it. Wonderful. Guys, both of you, can I just say, first of all, I thought that was a really lovely synchronized dance, really nice smooth movement throughout the piece. You used each other really well. That was that togetherness, which I think is so important as well. I like the moment you were sort of going around, and that was really lovely, and you were clearly watching each other very carefully. And also that lean, I think, was that the word? That lean at the end as well. A nice really finishing touch as well. So thank you very much indeed. Well done.
Very good, well done. Well done, very good. So we've got one more couple that we're going to enjoy dancing the waltz. Please give a warm welcome to Beatrice and Christopher.
This could be a fairy tale.
Beatrice and Christopher, there they are, fantastic. Come on over, Christopher. Wow, just step forward. Wow, that was amazing. You just look like you're enjoying it so much. You enjoy dancing?
Yeah, it's been very fun.
And Christopher, just capture for me your thoughts right now.
It was quite stressful.
Well, I tell you what, it didn't show, and that was wonderful to watch. I really enjoyed it. Shall we see what
was telling us that this was a European dance, and I felt it had a real European air about it. I kind of could, you know, transported to Paris in the 1930s. I love that skirt. It's absolutely beautiful. It was absolutely impeccable. Your concentration, your togetherness. There was a really, really strong narrative in this dance as well, which really held it together. And I loved it. I thought it was fantastic.
Yes, so I thought one thing that was very impressive, and a few of you have done this tonight, was actually taking the Viennese take on the waltz. And not only do you have to think about the timing and the footwork and the rise and fall and the frame as you would a normal waltz, you also have to do it about three times faster, which makes it that much more difficult. And as Miss Holmes said, your timing remained consistent and flawless throughout. One thing I was incredibly impressed with was not only your use of the promenade position, which is when both members of the couple are facing in the same direction and moving in that direction, which is a very, very tricky thing to do because it's very easy for shoulders to pop out and you end up doing all these funny things with your hold, which was very, very good. You also turned, which is one of the most difficult things to do and takes, in some cases, years and years to really get. And you had that lovely rotation. You came all the way across the floor. I'm sure everyone got to see, that, and then got to see every part of you, which was fantastic. And I really, really enjoyed it. Thank you.
So, should we get some numbers, please?
Nine.
A 10. 9. A 10. Well done. Okay. I'm not good enough at math to know what that means, so we better get them all up here, and we'll let the scorers work it all out for us. So, up you come, waltz dancers. That was fantastic. Let's give them a big round of applause as a group, shall we? We'll get some medals to you. Well, I have to say, it wasn't absolutely beautiful. I mean, Miss Mountfield, wouldn't you say it's just such a special dance to watch the Year 8s do?
Yes, absolutely. It made me feel as if I was in The Sound of Music, actually. That last sort of Captain Von Trapp standing with his hands in his back. Really lovely.
Okay.
Much-deserved medals for
absolutely,
everybody.
Yeah. All winners, remember, all won their respective class heats. Now, what have we got? Here we go. We've got always 1 point in it, but just edging it. In this section is Amelia and Lachlan. Well done. Wow. Wow, wasn't that close, huh? And well done to all of you. Well done to all of you. A truly special dance from all of you. So fantastic. We really enjoyed that. Ladies and gentlemen, the waltz.
Well, that was a fantastic first half.
What a great first half.
And I think, ladies and gentlemen, you can now go and enjoy yourselves. A big thank you to Chrissy and Jason Longley and the friends of Borlase, who are out behind you pouring into these very posh wine glasses that we're now using at Borlase, some refreshments for you. So do go and enjoy yourself. When are we due back?
Enjoy the apple juice. I'm not sure. Probably 5 minutes, I expect.
We need more than 5 minutes to sell those drinks.
We'll wait for the bell.
15 minutes. Somebody will send you back anyway. So off to the bar.
Okay, bye-bye.
That's all I've got. There it is, we've got Christmas crackers over here. They've been there for the whole first half. Come on, get your Christmas crackers over. It's half time.
Oh, good, excellent. Have a round.
Everybody ready for a big second half?
Second half will do, yes, part two.
So we're going to get things started.
No lemons, it was no lemons or oranges in the interval. There's lots of very good wine being drunk, which is nice to see.
There's a couple of lemons over there, though. They've been having a good time during the interval. Okay, so we've got a new category that we need to find out from our members of staff what we're looking for.
So who's going to talk to me? Mrs. Hindley?
Okay, so the jive originates from the States, and you see references right back as far as rock and roll or maybe Lindy Hop. It's really fun and energetic, so the energy should be going through the roof now, really lively. There's a kicks and flicks section which we should see, and we're looking for the dancer to be able to work in perfect unison, really long extension through the feet. Acrobatics as well, maybe.
Looking forward to that. We're looking forward to that, acrobatics.
The circus.
Okay, let's see then.
So let's give a big second half welcome to our first couple dancing the jive. It's Samantha and Sawn. Energetic start to the second half. Running out of breath. That was amazing. What did it feel like?
Hard.
Hard how?
Lots of moving.
We definitely got a sense of that. And tell me, how long in the making has this dance been, Samantha?
Probably a couple of weeks.
I'm speechless, so I'm going to hand the words over to our judges. Smile.
So, well done. Lovely start for the second half, so thank you very much indeed. Loads of kicks and flicks. What I was doing here was I sort of had the list that Mrs. Hindley went through, so I was sort of ticking off things. And I certainly could tick off energy, lively, kicks and flicks, and I really enjoyed that. A really nice start straight away with that sort of pointed toe. I'm sorry if I'm being untechnical, but pointed toe there. It was really fun and energetic. I thought you clearly were having fun doing it as well, and I really enjoyed watching that. So thank you very much indeed. Well done.
Thank you so much. So let's come to you.
Hello. There we go. I couldn't agree more. I think your movement, as you said, was... I mean, I thought you were going to bounce off the wall at one point. And your energy was insane. The fact that we've still got a roof on us and you've not flown through it, I think, is quite lucky. So I thought you did a great performance, and the fun was there. I think everyone enjoyed it. You could tell by the reaction, and thank you so much. It was great.
Thank you. Yes. I think you can all do lovely comments. Thank you, judges. Now the business end of your world. Let's get those scores, please.
An 8.
Thank you, judges. Very good scores. Well, thank you for that great start to the second half. Let's welcome our next couple dancing in the jive. We've got Sophia and Tallulah.
Dance at Jackie Bomb.
No adverts going on here, or other very good dance schools as well that you might dance at. And you're a dancer as well?
Yeah, I do dance as well.
Excellent, good. Well, you can see it coming through in those moves. Better move over to the judges, I think.
Oh, wow. Okay, how many tricks are in there? I don't know. I mean, that was absolutely brilliant. You had high kicks in there, splits, other things that I don't know names for. Absolutely brilliant. How it was exciting, it was enthusiastic, it was lively, it was bouncy. I love that song, by the way, and what a brilliant song that is to choose. You had a real poise and real posture. I just thought it was fantastic.
Again, pointed feet, and when you did the swish flicks, when you sort of use your knee and turned in and out, that is very technical, and you executed that perfectly, so well done, well done.
Thank you.
Okay, shall we have your scores?
Next dance, please welcome our third couple dancing the jive. Give it up for Annie and Harry.
Is it races down the hill? You can try to stop the
that you're taking. Are you insured to do that move, the one where you threw her?
Yeah.
Good, good. You need to be. That was special. That was fantastic. Well done. And so much energy. Are you tired?
I'm good, actually.
What about you, Harry?
I'm wiped.
Well, I'm wiped just watching it. Should we get some comments from our judges, please?
Wow. I think the first thing I thought when that song came on is they've got to really dance to this song. Yeah. I mean, I don't think you could have been stopped at all, frankly. And I thought that was really, really awesome. You were lightning fast. I'm slightly taken aback, to be honest. And I mean, your tricks. I think I don't need to say anything about them. Everyone else in this room is probably as mind blown as I am. So you know, all in all, absolutely fantastic. Thank you.
Mr. Mile.
Yeah, great song. Right, what do we have in here? Shimmy? That's the word, isn't it? Kicks and flicks, loads of them. Extension of the arms, you know that moment? Acrobatics, the leapfrog. I assume that's the technical term. Fantastic. And I would say synchronisation. I really enjoyed the whole thing. And you can't stop the beat, so thank you very much.
There we go. Some nice comments. Judge.
A 10.
Yeah. 2 tens. A 9. Oh wow, 3 tens and a 9. Well done. Have a seat. We're all wondering whether we would be able to do a leapfrog still, aren't we, or that acrobat? The answer's no, Mr. Mile. Okay, our fourth pair dancing the jive tonight, please give a big welcome to Edward and Rose.
After that, were you? That was such fast choreography, wasn't it? And who did the thinking behind the choreography? Yeah. But by agreement, it was a joint effort. You can tell it was a joint effort, couldn't you? Very impressive, both of you. Let's hear what the judges have got to say.
Can I just say, I absolutely love watching you dance, Edward. Honestly, I really do, because you just throw yourself into every time that I've seen you dance. You dance in boys' dance, don't you?
Yeah.
So when I've seen you dance in boys' dance as well, I can just see how much you love it and you enjoy it, and it really makes me happy. So thank you, Edward. Both of you, just so enthusiastic and lively, and I'm exhausted now, just watching that, to be honest with you. It was great, fantastic.
The energy that you were giving off. I mean, I felt like I was at a party. I didn't stop moving while I was watching you. And also, all of the jumps that you did, all the lifts that you did, it really felt like you had her. She didn't look worried at all, which is comforting for her, I'm sure. And, you know, all of your kicks and flicks, in time with each other, everything was, you know, you've obviously spent some time on it, and you've obviously set it all out quite well. So, thank you for that.
tell us is going to be close. So what do we think, judges?
Good scores. Well done, Rose. Well done. Well done. Very good. Good scores. Great dance. Oh, I can't believe
it. Very lively.
We've got...
How many couples have we had? We've got a couple left.
We've got one couple left, but this is... We're going to have the final, aren't we? And oh, hello.
Drinks. Drinks are coming round.
I didn't place an order, did you?
Thank you very much, Will.
Is this a magic show? Thank you, Will. I'm guessing that's going to be needed by our final couple of the evening in the heats, if that's what we want to call them.
Yes.
So please... Give up all your energy for Erin and Josh.
One, two, three, four.
That brings out some energy, and that was fantastic. Come over here, come over here. Come over, sweetie. Okay, tell me a little bit about that dance. How did you get to that point, Josh?
We did the heats, we got through, and then we added about 3 lifts into it.
And I saw the lifts. You were both lifting each other.
Yeah, it was quite hard to do because you were doing like lots of kicks, and then straight after I was...
I'm sorry, it was good work and great outfits, by the way. Let's get some. Let's get the people who know what they're talking about. Tim,
your synchronisation was 2AT phenomenal. Jive is my favourite dance. It's not a secret. I say it a lot. And if it is not everyone else's favourite dance in this room, having been convinced by that performance, I don't know what will. So, I love it.
Miss Holmes.
Are you sure it's me?
Oh, come on, Mr. Sorry. I'm not excluding you. What, Mr. Mark, my fault, I went out of order.
An expert should speak at the end, so let's do this. Guys, can I say, really difficult job to finish the entire evening, as much as difficult it is to start the evening, and everyone's had a difficult job and everyone's done really well, but actually, when you've seen everyone else go in front of you, it's so difficult to then prepare and be ready. So I want to say thank you very much, just that alone, brilliant achievement, so thank you. The use of the props, indeed, very, very good indeed. I did write that down. Really fast pace, really together, the synchronisation. You used each other really well. That move you mentioned a few minutes ago, where you know you lifted each other up, that was really impressive. And I just thought, yeah, you had all the kicks and flicks. A really lovely performance. Thank you for finishing the evening with that. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Mark. Okay, let's get some numbers.
The most convinced I've ever been about a 10.
Very good. Let's get all the dancers back on the stage, as in all the Jive dancers. Let me come. Fantastic.
Much more than I needed before. I want money and a meter and a nearby heater. Oh, and now it's getting on the road. So they're getting sweeter on the legs of my jeans and a head full of hair. Bought a pan and some shoes in my feet. I got a shelf full of books and most of my teeth. Few pairs of socks and a door with a lock. I got food in my belly and a license for my daily. And nothing's gonna bring me down.
Okay, so it was close, wasn't it? There was only one point in it. Some fantastic dancing from all of you. You're all winners, but we've got our finalists, haven't we? It's Erin and Josh. Well done, Erin and Josh. Okay, we'll say goodbye to you for now. Off you go. A big round of applause for our Jive dancers.
And that moves us on to our grand final, I think, Mr. Robertson.
This is where it really counts, isn't it? So we should just explain to you.
I'm too near. It's telling me I'm too near.
I know. Is it that? The dances that the judges have seen. Actually, we should explain to these guys as well, because they forget. They've got, like, memory, so it's 7 second sign. So these dances you're about to see are fresh. The dances that you've seen, wipe them from your memory. We're going to watch the finalists, but you're going to judge what you see in the final, which is coming up. Okay? I know you guys get it. I'm just talking slowly for Mr. Meyer.
And there'll be no scoring this time, because you're going to leave the space and you're going to decide who are our Strictly Come Dancing. What do we call them?
Winners.
Grand final. I can't remember what's on the medal. Winners. Champions. Thank you, Mrs. Heimke.
Yes. So you can
champions.
You can put your table tennis bats away. You'll go out there and you can take as long as you need, within reason, to come back and tell us your result. Our finalists will come in one at a time. They'll dance and then they'll wait for the other contestants to dance. So are you ready? Okay.
So should we bring in our first finalists?
Well, we should.
It must be the finalists from the salsa.
So let's welcome our finalists from the salsa.
Sinora, shake your body line. Shake, 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 Sinora, shake it all the time. Work, 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 Sinora, work your body line. Work, 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 Sinora, work it all the time. My girl's name is Sonora, I tell you friends I adore her. And when she dances, oh brother, she's a hurricane in all kinds of weather. Jump in the line, rock your body on time. Okay, I believe you, jump in the line, rock your body on time. Okay, I believe you, jump in the line, rock your body on time. Okay, I believe you, jump in the line, rock your body on time. Shake, 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 Sinora, shake your body line. Whoop. Shake, 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 Sinora, shake it all the time. Work, 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 Sinora, work your body line. Work, 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 Sinora.
Okay, well done, Noah. Well done, Nikita. Grab your seats. Okay, our second finalist, Dancing the Waltz. Please welcome Amelia and Lachlan.
This could be our fairy tale. They'll play the villains for us.
And I'd give up forever to touch you, 'cause I know that you feel me so. You're the closest to heaven that I'll ever be, and I don't wanna go home right now. And all I could taste is this moment, and all I can breathe is your life. And sooner or later it's over, I just don't wanna.
Okay, grab your seats. Thank you. Well done. Okay, and our final finalists, Dancing the Jive. Please welcome back Erin and Josh.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Thank you, Josh. Well done. Grab your seats. Very good. Very good. What a wonderful final that was. Grand final.
Absolutely. Fantastic. You took your Will's job for him, Mr. Robertson. Thank you very much, Will.
Sorry, Will.
And it goes in that direction. Really well done, all of you.
Okay. Well, so clear off you guys. You've got to go and do some talking outside. Good luck with that. Wow. I don't envy you at all.
No. Very, very difficult job ahead.
Okay.
Meanwhile, are you going to take your wine with you? That might help. That might make things a little bit easier. Meanwhile, we're going to have some entertainment. Would you like to stay for the entertainment finalists? Good. We're going to have our Latin and Ballroom group. They're going to perform for you. It's fantastic that our Latin and Ballroom group, and Imogen and Tim were both really instrumental in getting Latin and Ballroom up and running at school here. And it's continued since that whole period. So I'm really looking forward to some exhibition dancing.
Yes, let's enjoy it, ladies and gentlemen.
Let's see it.
Our Latin Ballroom. to talk to you.
It was wonderful.
That was amazing. You all look like you're having so much fun. So tell me a little bit, how do you get to this point? Tell us about your journey.
Well, I kind of choreographed this, stealing a lot from Harry's Feel It Still from 2 years ago. So the first few sessions are just learning basic moves, like the classic tongue, which you see in everything, and the kicks, and then I'll choreograph at home, we'll put it in the studio, and we'll change bits, and we'll mess it around with the final bits, just spacing it.
Brilliant. And have you got some new dancers, Laura, this time, in the company?
We have a lot of new dancers this year, which is really nice, and a lot of older years, which is really cool to see everyone get involved.
Excellent. Well, it's fantastic to see the London Ballroom dancers back up and dancing. And I know it's completely new for some of you, so brilliant for getting the club going again. Thank you. You've
given us a real treat. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, give a big round of applause for our London Ballroom dancers. Where do? You go? Do you stick around? I don't know. So we're getting word. It's a near-on fist fight out there. This is not easy, so I don't know what are we going to do. What do we do? Kill time? I'll do my Mr. Marley
impression. Christmas carol singing. Could possibly do a little bit of that.
Audience participation.
I don't know. We're allowed to do singing.
I tell you what we have done in the past. In the past, we've got some very enthusiastic younger siblings.
Former winners, actually.
To give it a go. What go-to music? This is completely improv. What go-to music could you give us in the box?
There you go, you missed. The music, they were just going to play you your favourite tune, Mr. Robinson. Yeah.
Chances passed, chances missed. They're on their way out. Judges, come on, here we go then.
Shouldn't we bring out all the contestants at this point, actually? I thought I'd forgotten something.
The most important people tonight are our contestants, and we should bring them out.
All back on for this moment. So we haven't forgotten about you, contestants. So if we bring our finalists, grand finalists, down to the front, please. And if we can have all our Strictly Come Dancing dancers back onto the stage, please. Can we have some music for them? On we come.
Welcome back, everyone. So this is what it's all about. I think, Tim, you're going to come up and do the honours, aren't you? You're going to come and be a spokesperson for the judges. Some wonderful name. This dates back to 2009. And I think it went on a couple of years before that, but there's some big names on here. I tell you, look at that. Pete Sampras.
Right, well, first of all, I think we owe everyone standing in front of me now a massive, massive round of applause. This is lighter than I thought it'd be. I never got the chance to compete for it, so this in itself is a win for me, to be honest. Now, as you can tell, the final was very, very closely contested. We spent quite a while arguing. Arguing is the correct word. It did get quite fiery in there. But in the end, it did come down to the technicalities of footwork and the part of the foot that's on the floor. It was serious, serious stuff. And I'm very pleased to say that the champion of this year's Strictly Come Dancing at Ballets, our very own Cinderella and Prince Charming. It's the Two for the Waltz.
Amelia and Lachlan, ladies and gentlemen.
Popular winners, I think. Very, very difficult judging, I'm sure, but really, really well done to all our grand finalists and all our finalists. Before we all start having a free dance, and make sure you don't lose these positions so we can take plenty of photographs of you, and mums and dads and family, if you want to take photographs, feel free to do that. We'll hold them. We'll hold them for a moment so you can do that. But before we do that, I do have some thank yous. Thank you to Jenny and the technical team. You've been absolutely brilliant this evening. Thank you to our judges over here. We've got to thank them, I think, Mr. Robertson, for all they've done, all their technical expertise.
Great job, judges. Great job.
And the people who did all the hard work leading up to tonight and during tonight, thank you to Mix Tucker and to Mrs. Hindley and to Mrs. Ashby, who stayed behind the scenes all evening, running the show from behind, as well as doing the choreography. So thank you very, very much to all of you in the dance department. That's absolutely brilliant.
Can I just say a big thank you to our presenters, who's been fantastic.
Thank you very much.
Lights up as well, I think. Thank you very, very much indeed. And I think our message from there, actually, is just going to be here.
Keep dancing.
Steps around the tree. Let's get you two front and centre here. A bit further forward, you two, so we can get that kind of detail. Yeah, so I would say.
And do feel free to come down and take your memory snaps.